What's up, Rob here. You're watching Man vs. Pim, the show where all of your Pinterest dreams eventually go to die. Suggested by Alexa of Alexa's DIY Life, and liked up by a shit ton of you, reusable bubbles. Originally posted on the amazing blog toodaloo.com, these bubbles are technically made using the same technique and ingredients as the insanely popular galaxy slime. Alright, enough yippy-yapping. To make this project, well, you're gonna need all this shit. To start, I poured half a bottle of clear Elmer's glue into a small bowl, followed by some liquid watercolor and some glitter. After giving it a quick stir, I added a small amount of liquid starch. The amount of liquid starch that you use is really the secret here. So much so that I don't even know it. I just kept on adding in small amounts of liquid starch as instructed, and just kept on mixing until I thought that I had the right consistency. And already from the start, this first batch turned to shit. I used, I guess, too much liquid starch, and it got a little too runny and liquidy and soapy. I tried adding more glue to balance it out, but that was a horrible idea. All right, let's give it another go. Half a bottle of glue, liquid watercolor, glitter, mix, and this time I'm adding just a tiny amount of liquid starch. Little bits at a time until I get it right. Taking my time here. Now this chapstick ain't doing shit. I had to get in there and mix it with my hands. Wait, where the f*** is my wedding ring? Oh, all right. After a couple more applications of the liquid starch, it finally reached the galaxy slime level. Now the pin says that at this point, in order to get the right consistency for the bubbles, you need to add more liquid starch, till the point that when you stretch it, it breaks apart like this. After trying the stretch test, everything seemed to be in order. I rolled it into a small ball, grabbed myself a large straw, and drove it straight into the middle. Gave it a couple puffs, and nothing, really. Turns out there's a little more to it than just sticking a straw into it. You kind of gotta twist it around and make sure that everything's tightly sealed. But once you get that down, it's bubble time, motherfuckers. There you go. That's the stuff. Stuff that Pinterest dreams are made of. I think I got the best bubbles when I used a smaller amount on the tip of the straw opposed to a huge blob of it. But, you know, it was all pretty much the same shit. If I was like 7, this would have been the jam. But I'm not. And there you have it. Reusable bubbles. Fun for the whole family. Now, as far as reusing these bubbles, I have absolutely no idea what I would reuse them for. I thought maybe like a candle? No. I tried reusing it as some kind of kinky sex toy.
Ew, what is that? No, that's not okay.
Clearly not. Oddly enough, I tried reusing it as an iPhone charger and it worked. Huh, look at that. Things I need from you. Number one, subscribe if you haven't already. You will not be disappointed. And if you are, unsubscribe. Jerk. The second thing, I'm going to be doing a little Q&A over on my personal channel, so be sure to leave whatever sadistic, fucked up questions that you want in the comments below, and I'll post my responses over there. Third thing, follow me on Twitter for some fucking reason. I don't know. Just seems like something I should say. And last but not least, no, that's it. We're done.